All, welcome to CENTUM Academy YouTube live session on Parabola. So those who have joined in the session, request you to type your name in the chat box so that I know who all are attending the session. So this session is going to be the very, very basic of the Parabola. We are going to just introduce Parabola here in this session. And of course, we'll be solving a lot of problems on the basic concepts of Parabola. So those who have joined in the session, I would request you again, please type in your name in the chat box. All right, so we'll begin the session. I'm assuming many of you are traveling right now. So we'll start with the very basic definition of a parabola. So how do we define a parabola? As a locus. So we'll start with the parabola definition. So parabola is defined as the locus of a point, which moves in a plane, such that its distance from a fixed point, is always equal, to its distance from a fixed line, Okay, this fixed point is actually called as the focus, and this fixed line is actually called the directrix. Okay, now by the use of this definition, I would be actually deriving the equation of a parabola, which we call as the standard case of a parabola. But before that, I would just apprise you of the basic terminologies that we used when we are referring to a parabola. Okay. So let's say this is my fixed line, the line which you can see in the red. And this is the fixed point, the point which you can see in your white. Okay, let's take this point to be a point A comma 0 for the purpose of simplicity, and let's take this directrix to be the line x equal to minus of A, right? And this point here I would be taking as the origin, that is the meeting of the x and the y axes. Now, how is basically a parabola defined? It's the locus of all such point h comma k, which moves in such a way that its distance from this fixed line, that is this distance, let me call it as PM, is same as the distance from the fixed point, let's call PS. Okay, so as per the locus definition, PM should be equal to PS. Okay, now by using the concept of locus, we can derive the equation of this case of a parabola, which we normally call as a standard parabola. So we take the distance PS as h minus a the whole square, k minus 0 the whole square, under root, and the distance PM is nothing but h plus a mod. When we square both the sides, we get h minus a square plus k square is equal to h square plus a square plus 2hk. On expanding the terms, we get this expression. Where h square and h square and a square can be cancelled from both the sides. giving us the equation as k square, sorry, not hk, it will be ha. Yeah, so giving the equation as k square is equal to 4ah, which we can generalize as y square is equal to 4ax. Okay, so this is the case of a standard parabola. You will realize that we refer to four cases of a parabola as standard parabola, and one of them is y square is equal to 4ax. The other three I'll be telling you in some time, but before that, few terms that we need to be aware of. For example, this particular line which divides the parabola into two symmetrical halves is called the axis of the parabola. Okay. Of course, S is called the focus. This red line is called the directrix. This point 0, 0 in this case, it is called the vertex. Okay. A line connecting any two points on the parabola, that is called the, let's say I connect any these two points, this will be called as the chord. So this I'll be calling as the chord of the parabola. Okay. A line which is perpendicular to the axis of a parabola and connecting two points, this line is called the double ordinate. This point is called the double ordinate. Okay. And a line which is passing through the focus of the parabola and connecting any two points, as you can see, I've drawn it in pink, that will be called the focal chord. Okay. So you can say focal chord is a chord which passes through the focus. Okay. And finally, the chord which is perpendicular to the axis and passes through the focus, that is called the latus rectum. This is most important. Latus rectum, shortest line in Greek, it means shortest line. Why it is called the shortest line is because later you will learn latus rectum is basically the shortest focal chord. Latus rectum is the shortest focal chord, right? So you can say latus rectum is nothing but a double ordinate, which is actually also the focal chord, or a focal chord, which is also the double ordinate. Okay. So these are the terms that normally we use while referring to, a parabola. Now I'll introduce you to other forms of the parabola as well. So let's talk about other forms of the parabola. So a parabola which opens to the left side. Okay, so such a case of a parabola which opens to the left side, right, it has its focus at minus a comma 0 and its directrix is x equal to a. So its directrix is given as x equal to a. Okay, and of course the axis is the x-axis itself and the vertex is at origin. Okay, so such a parabola has the equation such a parabola has the equation y square is equal to minus 4ax. Thus, the parabola has the equation y square is equal to minus 4x. Remember, in all cases of a parabola, a is always positive. So always remember this. We always keep our a as positive, no matter whatever is the parabola we are dealing with. Normally, a is something which we used to denote, which we used to denote the distance of vertex from the focus, right? Or it's the distance between the vertex and the focus, hence we always keep it as a positive distance. So this is the second case of a parabola. This is also a case of a standard parabola. Coming to the third case is a parabola where the parabola will open upwards. Okay. In such case, the focus would be at 0, A. This would be your focus, 0, A. And directrix will be the line, y is equal to minus A. Okay, and the vertex is 0, 0 again. The vertex is here 0, 0 again, but this time the axis of the parabola is the y axis. So here this was the axis of the parabola. In this case, the axis of the parabola will be your y axis. Okay, such a parabola equation is given as x square is equal to 4ay. Now, you would realize that this parabola equation is obtained from the first parabola equation by replacing x with y. That means you're trying to reflect the previous parabola. Basically, this is obtained by reflecting y square is equal to 4ax parabola about the line y equal to x. Okay. So whenever you reflect something about the line y equal to x, I'll just tell you a thumb rule. What we do is we interchange the position of x and y. So moving on to the fourth case. In this case, the parabola will be the one which opens downwards. The one which opens downwards. Like this. Okay. So here your vertex is still at origin. Focus now will become 0, -a. And the equation of the directrix. The equation of the directrix will become y is equal to a. Note that again y axis is the axis of the parabola. Okay, and in such cases the equation of the parabola would be given as x square is equal to minus 4ay. So I would like you all to remember these four cases very clearly in your mind, because I'll be doing the general equation of a parabola in these standard cases. So please remember all the four standard cases of a parabola. Okay. Meanwhile, we'll just start solving some problems. My first problem would be based on finding the equation of any parabola in general. Right. So follow the basic definition, which is the locus of a point whose distance from a fixed point is same as the distance from a fixed line. So I'll be starting with problem based on the locus definition of a parabola. Okay. So I'll start with the very first question. Find the equation of the parabola whose focus is at -1, -2 and directrix is x -2y+3 = 0. So please try this out. I'm giving you 1 minute time to try it out. Yeah. So let's discuss this question. So let me draw a case of a parabola whose focus is at -1, -2. So -1, -2 will be a line point over here. Okay. And this is going to be a line with a positive slope. Slope is going to be half. Cutting the x-axis at -3. So somewhat like this would be the directrix. So somewhat like this, okay? And we have to draw a parabola like this. So your parabola would be of this nature. As you can see, this is the axis of the parabola. As you can see, the dotted white line, okay? Axis is always perpendicular to the directrix. So a couple of things that you should know. Axis is always perpendicular to the directrix. Number one, axis is always perpendicular to the directrix. Okay. Number two, the vertex is always the midpoint between the focus and the point where the axis meets the directrix. So V is the midpoint of S and N. The vertex is always the midpoint of the focus and the point where the axis meets the directrix. Okay. However, these things may not be useful in solving this particular problem, but this should be known. You should be aware of this. Okay. Now, here I will use the basic definition. I'll say let the point whose locus I am finding is h, k. Okay. So this distance and this distance must be same. Okay. So SP should be equal to PM. SP should be equal to PM. So what is SP? SP would be h+1 to the whole square under root is equal to PM. PM is the distance of a point from a line. And we have already learned this in given as and divide by the square of the coefficient of NY. Okay. So it becomes h -2+3. Yeah. Mod by under root of 1² + 2². Okay. So if I square both the sides, I get h+1² k+2² is equal to h -2k+3² by 5. Okay. So let us simplify this. So it becomes 5 times h+1² 2² +9 -4hk +6h -12k. On further verification, this will give me 5 times h square 10h plus 5 plus 5k square plus 20k plus 20 equal to h square plus 4k square plus 9 minus 4hk plus 6h minus 12k. So let's simplify this. So I'll get 4h square, right, by taking care of these two terms, right? And 4k square and 5k square will leave me with a k square term. Okay. Then I will have a 4hk term coming from here. Then I'll have a 4h term coming from these two terms. Then I'll have 32k term coming from these two terms. And then finally, I'll have plus 16. Now, this is the relationship between h and k. And now we need to generalize this. Now we need to generalize this to get the equation of our parabola. 4 plus 4x2y plus 16 equal to 0. Right? Equation of parabola minus comma minus 1 comma minus 2 and directrix is x minus 2y plus c. So as you can see, guys, it can be as complicated as this. Okay, so we had seen the equation of four standard cases, that is y square is equal to 4ax, y square is equal to minus 4ax, x square is equal to 4ay, x square is equal to minus 4ay. And here in front of you, you have another version of an equation of a parabola, which is very, very complicated one, right? So remember all the conic. Just remember all the conic equation is basically of this nature. Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Okay, and in particular, when you're dealing with a parabola, I have already told you in the very first class, in case of a parabola, h square should be equal to ab. Is it happening in this case? Please verify. H is going to be, this is 2h, so h is going to be 2. So 2 square is equal to ab. This is your a and this one is your b, so 4 into 1. So that is happening. So that's the further verification that we can do for this case. Okay, so this is the case of a parabola because it is satisfying h square equal to ab condition on the general equation of a parabola. Okay, in a similar line,